Good morning! Today is June 5th, 2020, and this is The Morning Breach with Scott Davis. This morning, we're going to begin with the Kentucky Employees Health Plan, which has suffered two data breaches back-to-back. The first attack, from April 21st through April 27th, had a bad actor used a valid login credential to infiltrate a third-party vendor, where they accessed biometric screening and health assessment data, including the claiming of over $100,000 worth of point redemptions. Staywell, the third party, took the site offline to improve security. And then a second breach occurred from May 22nd to May 22nd, and that found 42 of the original 971 targeted members also had their Commonwealth email account infiltrated. It is believed that those users utilize the same password for both systems. So once a cyber criminal gains access to your network, they often leave a vulnerability open for future attacks. You should, as an organization, deploy single sign-on and multi-factor authentication for every system that can be enabled on. And that's the same for personal use. If you can enable multi-factor authentication, you should do it. So the value of single sign-on is users can use the same password, and once it's detected as breached, the user changes it and it updates all the other sites with that one password. So it's great for business use. Multi-factor authentication is the most critical component here. It creates a second step verification of the user for the first time logging in somewhere new, or if they just haven't logged in for a while. So if you're not using MFA or 2FA, then it's time to deploy it. If you're not sure how, then message me or post a comment below. There's actually three-factor authentication is also starting to come out. That's, you know, for those uber secure networks where you're getting actually three forms of authentication instead of just two. So if three's coming out, two's been out, and you're still using one, then you're not secure. The NetWalker ransomware gang has hit three universities in the last 7 days. Now, previously, we reported on Michigan State University last week, but they also hit University of California San Francisco, or UCSF, and the Columbia College of Chicago. NetWalker is a strain of ransomware that will publish or sell the data if the ransom's not paid, and the timer is already clicking on when they're going to release the data. Post Falls Police Department in Washington was the target of a cyber attack on May 23rd. Based on the fact that the police chief, Pat Knight, stated that he and others were unable to use their official email addresses, indicate that this was a form of ransomware. Now, it's not sure if a breach has occurred, because in the statement from the police department, they didn't announce what variant of ransomware was used, so there is still a lot of questions on this. In other news, another new ransomware variant has been found, and it's currently targeting both Windows and Linux PCs. It's being called Tycoon, and it appears the cyber criminals behind it are highly selective in its targets and is very unique compared to other ransomware variants and strains that are in the wild. Tycoon is completed, it's completely developed in Java. It's deployed as a Trojanized Java runtime environment, and it's compiled as a Java image file. So all of these are rarely used for the intended steps, but they have successfully done it and also have managed to obscure their code extremely well into the steps. Now, despite all the hard work that went into development, its primary method of attack is still common. It's where they're targeting insecure RDP servers. And that's why they're being as selective as they are. So business process outsourcing firm Conduit has confirmed its European operations were hit with the Maze ransomware on May 29th. So there's still threats coming out. There's always something new. And as always, if you've learned something new by watching this, take a few seconds, like, and share the video. If you want to see more episodes of The Morning Breach, follow, connect with me, subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching. Have yourselves a great weekend, and I will see you back here Monday morning.